Welcome everybody to another Voice of Nick show. It's a late one, 1:34 in the AM, and we're starting another game this time. We have in front of us Enter the Matrix, circa 2003 for the PS2. Always had a really cool box. If you can see the cover art, it's like holographic, so that it kind of looks like the Matrix code is moving. I always thought that was cool when I was a kid. And I just watched the Matrix 1 and 2, so what better thing to do than play the tie-in game that came out right between 2 and 3. Let's get the ceremonial games list here before we kick off the festivities, and then we'll see what this game was about. I don't know if I ever finished Enter the Matrix when I was a kid. Or, I don't know, not a kid, but, yeah, a kid. Enter the Matrix, 2003, PS2. Good stuff. It's on the list now, ladies and gents. So we're going to jump in it, and we shall see what's going on with this. Welcome Dirtbag Face to the show. Let's get an exclamation mark high for Dirtbag Face. Wish I could raid you. Love what you stream. You're on Duolingo learning Japanese now. Good stuff. Well, first of all, thanks. Yeah, I don't allow raids on the channel, but I appreciate the sentiment. And ganbatte kudasai. Do your best. And good luck to you with the Japanese studying. How many days are you up to? Welcome into the show. We're starting off the game right about... Can I hit it from under? No, I think I have to go over. We're going to restart the PS2, ladies and gents. Here we go.
Restart the PS2.
Cool. This stuff will have to set once we get in it. Doesn't seem to be changing anything. Why are they all so low? I'll just leave it where it was. Hacking. Alright, well, we won't do anything here. Dirtbag facing, been 2 months learning Japanese. Good stuff. Well, good luck to you. Excited for the game. Thanks for the inspiration. I'm glad that that it's inspiring to you then. Good stuff. Here we go.
Flies to cow pies, crawling over every drop we ever used.
We didn't have a lot of time.
A lot of time? Wrong. We don't have a little time. Look, I don't mean to be Mr. Naysay, but you really think you got a chance in hell at getting to that thing before they find it?
I don't know, but that won't stop her from trying.
Come on, Ghost. It's crazy.
Sparks, how long have you been operating on this ship?
3 years.
And you ought to know by now. When she makes up her mind, you have one choice. You go with her, or you get the hell out of her way.
Drop still clean.
Niobe, this won't be easy.
Thaddeus was my friend. I knew him. He never used a drop before. He didn't trust him. Whatever's in that box cost Thaddeus his life and the lives of his crew. And I have a feeling if we don't get to it first, it's gonna cost us a whole lot more. So are you red or blue on this?
You know me, Niobe. It's not a choice. It's a way of life.
Because I know how valued my opinion is on this ship, I won't bother to tell you. But I think it's insane for you not to wait for a support team. And for the record, when I cart your bodies back to Zion, do you prefer cremation or the gardens?
Sparks, your faith in us remains a source of personal inspiration.
Well, I am what I am, and I do what I can.
Then can you shut up and hit the button?
Your wish, Captain. My captain is my keystroke colon double backslash execute command.
Wow, cool. So the thing I didn't mention that I probably should have before starting, little context for anybody who's not familiar with Enter the Matrix, you may see on the front of the box, written and directed by the Wachowskis. So, for example, the stuff that we just watched right there, that was not, like, clips from the movie or something. That was bespoke content that they shot specifically for this game only. So this game is, like, a story that takes place within the Matrix universe, I guess, like, during the second Matrix film. But it's not, like, retelling stuff from the Matrix or, like, using clips from the Matrix. This is, like, a completely separate thing of its own. Which I always thought was really admirable from a creation standpoint. All right, well, we gotta be Jada Pinkett Smith here. A piece of dust flying around my room. Probably because I haven't played this PS2 in such a long time. There was a lot of dust flying around a second ago.
Why do you do that?
Do what?
Check your guns.
You never know.
It's a program. They get loaded every time the exact same way.
Hume teaches us that no matter how many times you drop a stone and it falls to the floor, you never know what'll happen the next time you drop it. It might fall to the floor, but then again it might float to the ceiling. Past experience can never prove the future.
So?
So you never know.
Here we go. We're in.
You got 10 minutes.
Until the post office closes. There's a ton of heat in the area, but the package is still untouched. Box number is
731222.
Got it.
And hey, can you ask Ghost if he doesn't make it? Can I have his boots?
Your call, inside or out?
I'll get the package.
Keep in touch.
Yeah, I guess. Oh, wow.
Thank you for visiting the post office. We are now closing. This office is open 7 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., Monday to Saturday. Please exit through the main doors.
Oh, wow. So it's a tank control. That's why they didn't have any controls menu. Ah, and they don't let us change the settings. Okay, so since we just saved it, we will now change our settings and come back in. I would like to see if the brightness thing works for the cutscenes, because it was really dark. And also, if we could turn up the volume in the cutscenes. Not sure. I guess we'll find out.
Operator. Operator.
Operator.
Operator.
You never know, though, if this is gonna, like, blow out the... Wait, what? Oh, yeah. So we're gonna have to see if this works right. I love how stylishly this is directed so far. I'm really impressed. Fun fact, I was reading about The Matrix 1, that the Wachowskis were huge fans of Hideo Kojima. They actually, apparently the first like game that they played right after Matrix came out was Metal Gear Solid.
We are now closing.
And they were like so impressed by it, apparently.
7 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., Monday to Saturday. Please exit through the main doors in the central lobby.
Okay, so it's kind of hard not to just run then.
Ma'am, we're closing.
Pardon me, ma'am.
See you later.
We're closed. You're gonna have to leave now.
Tips menu. No tips available. Thanks for that. Find and retrieve the package. So am I just choosing what door I want? Oh, press action button. Square. Oh, okay.
Sparks, the elevator shut down.
Yeah, I know. Okay, I've got a blueprint online. No, it's too bad. That elevator would have worked. Okay, hold on. I'm looking for another way.
I
found a heavy mail elevator in the back corner of the main sorting area. It might still be operating.
Thanks.
I can go in here? Move toward a target and press throw punch or something. Whoa. Okay. I think I figured out the secret before they meant for me to figure it out. Well, we're just too smart for them. It's interesting that they use real text in this, the Matrix scroll thing. I don't think I ever recognized it because I couldn't read Japanese at the time.
Did you hear about the TCS reports?
The new cover sheets?
Oh, you got the memo.
Hey, so did they fix the printer?
I hear there's a problem with the toner.
Are they going to give me a tip about it? Oh, here we go. Okay. To unlock some of your character's more useful and spectacular abilities within the Matrix, focus their minds by holding down focus while running, jumping, and fighting. Alright, it doesn't tell me how to do it, though. The focus meter in the bottom right of the screen shows your available pool of focus time, which regenerates over time. As you gain focus experience along the way, you'll discover even more special abilities. Press and hold focus to enter focus time, release to exit focus time. Another thing that I always thought was interesting about this game is that between the release of The Matrix, which kind of popularized, as far as I'm aware, popularized the term bullet time, between the release of The Matrix and this, the video game that ended up using a bullet time feature, Max Payne came out, which then used the term bullet time, and I'm pretty sure that, or at least when I was a kid, I always thought that they called it focus in this because they couldn't, like, Max Payne stole the copyright for bullet time. I don't know if that's true, though. Hold down focus and press jump while running, and you'll bend the rules of the Matrix for a super long jump. They're useful for crossing large gaps and for escaping enemies. Okay, I guess we have to look up the controls then. Focus is what? It doesn't even say. Hold for secondary, zoom in first person, X and square, jump kick, punch. It's so funny that PS2 games always had a separate button for kick and punch. Like as if you'd ever need a separate button for that. And then there's a throw button. Strafe right, strafe left. So we can strafe, it's not total, I guess that's the same as like Silent Hill 1 tank controls, where you could strafe and it's a tank. Pause, fire, oh, focus, L1, okay. The last thing I saw.
What do you think about that new guy?
He's okay.
Now can I do like a strafe focus jump? Oh! Why did I shoot them? Sorry. Oh my god, I'm running! Wow, cool. Oh god, I don't have a... Whoa! Oh my god! Wow, this game's great. Is that a health pack? Oh my god, there's a lot of cool animations in this. I don't know if they would have even attacked me on sight. I probably shouldn't have attacked them first. It seems like the game really wants you to read these tips. Your character will automatically enter hand-to-hand combat mode if you move toward an enemy and attack with a throw, punch, or kick. Sometimes you may want to exit hand-to-hand combat mode before the fight is over, such as when running from agents. To exit hand-to-hand combat mode, either move away from the enemy, press fire, or press the enter-exit first-person mode, which I guess is the right stick. How do I get more ammo? Do those guys have guns? No, I don't think so. What was the weapon menu? Okay, so I wasted all my bullets right at the outset there. Alright, so what we'll do. I guess we'll just try to grab the first gun we find. They have some really nice animations in this game. I love that, like, vault over table animation. Powerade! I can actually get a Powerade!
What did you get today?
I can't actually drink the Powerade, though. But it's very conspicuously is a Powerade. I can't crouch, either.
What do you got in yours? I got baloney.
Look, we need help in here!
Starting trouble,
huh? Uh-oh. Oh my god. Oh god, wow. Good one. Holy crap. There you go. Picking up firearms. Oh my god. In the Matrix, you will encounter a variety of firearms with different strengths and weaknesses. It's important to understand which weapons are best for any given situation. Your character will automatically pick up available firearms on the ground, just run over them. The icon in the upper right corner of your screen indicates your current selected firearm. Your character will automatically toss away weapons that have run out of ammo. If you need more ammo, you'll have to find another gun. That's a cool feature. I always thought that was cool in the darkness, where he wouldn't reload his gun, he would just throw the gun away and grab another one. I guess, like the Matrix. Firing and holstering firearms. To draw and fire a weapon, press fire. To holster a weapon, press action, which I guess was square. Good stuff. Welcome Linky Link into the show. In case you're not aware of of the way that we do it on here, we do request nobody use any of their pre-existing knowledge or opinions of the game, which includes like any kind of tips and stuff like that. One of your favorite games from childhood. Good stuff. Yeah, I used to love this game. I don't know if I ever finished it though when I was a kid. Hello. See, I probably shouldn't be beating up the guys that that are not fighting me. At least we're not killing them. So that's okay, that's punch. Square doesn't do any combat stuff. You're looking for the main sorting room. It's a huge room. Okay, so they're basically giving us a pity hint. Oh god, it's actually a really fluid animation system. Oh my god, I keep beating up the guys that aren't trying to fight me. Sorry. See, that guy is fine. We're not gonna hurt him. Unless, is he coming for us? No, he's just getting down. That's a really interesting feature. I've almost never seen that in a game. But yeah, like, not every security guard is willing to just, like, die for his job. I don't think many security guards would be willing to die for their job, to be honest. Who would be? Dive through glass. Sometimes you'll need to get to an objective or escape an enemy by any means necessary. Kick through glass windows by running directly at them and hitting kick. Different types of martial arts throws are available by mixing combinations of throw with movement. If you find yourself surrounded, you can attack multiple enemies at once from nearly all angles. Tap movement in the direction of an offline opponent. Offline? By pressing punch, kick, or throw, and you'll throw a punch at an enemy behind you, and so forth. Okay. Hold down focus while fighting multiple enemies to unleash additional special attacks. Okay. Cool. Oh, see, look, this guy got down. Very obliging of him. Appreciate that. Thank you, Link, saying no backseating. It's my first time. All good. Yep. It is understood. Oh, see, yeah, now they're giving us the arrow all the time. It might just be because it thinks we can't figure out where we're supposed to go. Oh! Wow! They're killing it on the animations. What are you gonna say about it? This guy's coming for us. Oh, so they're giving us health packs if we hypothetically needed health packs. I know what I'm gonna be doing for the rest of this game.
I've never seen security!
Don't call security and then act like I'm not gonna beat you up. You're getting a kick for that. Just one kick. These guys are all doing their thing. Oh, I love that you, like, butt up against the door with your shoulder. That's great. Again, they really went out of the way for a lot of these animations. Oh, yeah, I guess. Now, is it not letting me do multiple save slots? Because I would really prefer... We've had bad experiences with single save slots on here. Okay, so... We're gonna see if we can learn some more moves. Oh. Wow. Nobody seems to know where we are. Oh, these guys are gonna know.
I think they're expecting you.
Cops are everywhere on that second floor. I'm calling your partner for backup.
I have generous saves, at least. I appreciate that. It's interesting that I think every Japanese character is backwards, but they're just flipped. Yeah, I'm pretty sure all of them are flipped.
I thought security had the elevator covered.
Woohoo! How do I reload my firearms? Oh my god. Oh, that's cool. Now give me your guns. Wait, how do I use this health? Oh, I already have full health. Alright, hold on. Really killing the pacing here. If there is ammo available, your character will automatically reload their selected weapon when necessary. It's important to pay attention to a weapon's available ammo, so you don't find yourself running out of ammo and trying to reload in the middle of a firefight. Okay. To select a firearm or throwable weapon, press Weapons menu. Once within, press Weapon Select left or right to switch between the weapons and thrown weapons. Press Weapon Select up or down to select a weapon from the list, then press Jump to select a weapon and return to the game. Alternatively, you can quickly cycle through your firearms during gameplay while using Weapon Select by using left or right. Okay. Left or right. Or up and down, or is it just left or right? Oh, wow, we got an assault rifle, or SM... It says SMG, but that looks like a full-on assault rifle to me. Oh, jeez. Their weapons are disappearing after a while. Crap. Come out here. Shooting around corners. It's wanted. Face an object, such as a wall, then tap movement forward as if to walk into the wall. Your character will turn their back and press up against the object. Using walls and objects as cover will help you avoid some enemies and surprise others. When in a wall press, strafe left and right or move left and right to move along the object. By doing this, you can avoid calling attention to yourself. Tap movement down to exit the wall and press and move away from the wall. When in a wall press, sidestep left and right or move left and right to shuffle to the edge of the object. Keep moving towards the edge and your character will look around the corner. Looking around corners is a good way to pinpoint enemies without exposing yourself. While looking around a corner, press fire to step out and start shooting. Shooting around corners is a good way to use available cover. Hey, welcome Azure Tundra to the show. Silent Hill 1 difficulties. It's similar control system for sure. How are you doing, Azure Tundra? A late one, or an early one for you, possibly. Very early. Oh no, we have very low ammo here. Ah! Okay, oh yeah, we can get against the wall. Where's this guy? Oh, look at that, there's health over here. Oh jeez. Get against the wall! Or is it only... like full size walls. Get against this wall. What are you? Okay, Niobe, come on. How are we gonna save Zion like that? Down on the. Shoot! Oh my God! Holy crap!
Toxic, you gotta stay up high, away from that stuff.
The cops are sealing the doors outside. Ghost is getting slowed down, so you're on your own for now.
Uh-oh. not hitting a damn thing. Oh, baby! That's not good. Yowza, this is bad. We're done for. Get out of there, Niobe. No! How do I get back up? 1%! Oh! We're one with the Matrix. Yes. How was I supposed to jump across that? I probably wasn't supposed to jump laterally. I think I was supposed to climb something. But it wasn't clear to me how I was supposed to do that. Maybe I could have gone backwards and gone around?
I thought security had the elevator.
Okay. That's a little upsetting. Damn, these guys don't carry very much ammo on them. Line heading out. Until next time, sorry for not seeing the tag. Yeah, again, no problem. You know, not everybody knows everything when they come into the stream for the first time. But thanks for being a part of the show. God, these guys don't drop very much ammo at all. Oh! Cool! Whoa, he beat us up. I guess good for him, you know? Score one for these guys. So we know we're gonna get locked out of this room in a second, so we'll use the health kit, but otherwise we probably shouldn't be using it. All right, here we go. Now what the hell am I supposed to do here? I can't manually save. Can I shoot from the first person? Oh yeah, wow. Okay. I can't get through here. Oh, maybe I can do like a wall run. Oh, get it! Ah! Now we're dead. Niobe, get out of there. That was close though. So it was like, we did like a long jump instead. Alright, I see something. How would we get up there though? I don't know. We don't have any other guns. What? Like, why would they start me in front of this area here? Alright, it's gotta be that they want me to... Oh, here we go. Look for a skylight. They want me to go straight through the gas? No way! What do they expect me to do? I guess they just wanted me to do it quickly? Ah, Jesus. Oh my god. Damn! I don't really understand what they want me to do in this part. Like, they made a very specific point about, like, don't touch the ground. But then they're pointing me that way, and there's no way for me to get through there unless I touch the ground. If we take out the guys, I guess... off, you had a coffee a bit late. Yeah. I got some decaf actually so that I could drink at night. Because I've always said like coffee doesn't affect me, but then I was wondering like maybe it does. It's probably one of those things where I just think it doesn't affect me. So I'm trying it out. It takes so long for her to take out her gun. Now I wonder if Ghost's level is like a different level or if it's just a different character. Because within the canon, it seems like Ghost was in like a different area. Line up here. That's not gonna work. So this, you can't invert it. Oh, I don't have any bullets left. Damn. That's an unexpected turn of events. Now what? There's gotta be something I can do here. There you go. Run! Approach the base of the ledge or wall, tap. Your character will grab onto the ledge and hang from it. To drop down, press jump again. Press movement up, and your character will climb.
Thanks.
We gotta get out of here. The big thing is that we can't stay down there while we're getting shot, because that's the big 1-2 punch. The gas doesn't really kill us very quickly. Yeah, you can't invert the view here. Boom. Got him. That's it. Now we're playing the game. Is there getting the hype? Thank you, is there? Uh-oh. I hear guns, but I don't see anybody. Oh, so we keep all the ammo that we had from the previous level. So that could, we could kind of get ourselves into a corner here if we screw that up.
Don't try that with me.
Give me your gun. Oh wait, he had a gun, okay. All right. And go! What's on this TV? Oh, I think this is like security footage of a, SWAT team or something coming into the building. Oh, jeez. Whoa. Run. We'll just give them a second to think about what they're doing. Luckily, this game does actually replenish your health over time. Wow, that didn't really hit anything. Run! Now I don't have any guns either. Welcome, Mr. Sparkle, to the show. We're playing Enter the Matrix.
Box area is locked up tight. I don't see any way in.
Yeah, I noticed that.
And you didn't say anything.
There's a red conveyor belt that runs above the main sorting area. It's down the hall and to the left of where you are now.
Okay.
Find a spot where you can get onto the belt and ride it until it takes you over the P.O. box room.
And no one's supposed to see me when I'm up there.
Just act invisible.
Well, got a plan. Oh, Mr. Sparkle saying you had this on the GameCube? Nice. Yeah, this was an exciting time. Third Lord of the Rings movie was coming out. Was not out yet at this point. Matrix 2 had come out, but not 3. Animatrix was coming out. There's a lot of cool stuff happening.
By the PO box.
is it Jada Pinkett Smith's voice? Yeah, she also did like live action. So this game was directed and written by the Wachowskis, and like it's not like like most game movie tie-ins where they like retell the events of the movie. This is actually like all bespoke content, and so they shot like live action stuff with Jada Pinkett Smith and the other guy for this game only. It's really cool, it, like the production process for, or like the amount, the length they went to. But how do I do like a cool thing? Yeah, like, something like that. Alright, so I have. Damn, I never have enough ammo.
We can take it.
Oh god. The ammo also never seems to do a damn thing. It never hits anybody. Oh. Automatically duck. Crap. Oh my god, oh my god. What am I doing? Alright, that sort of worked out. Grab all the guns here. Oh, so it's saying 7 and 7 plus 3 more guns. I get what it's saying. I thought it was saying we had, like, a total of, you know, 14, 17 shots. This game is fast-paced when you're not, you know, dying and having to start the whole level over. Mr. Sparkle saying the golden years. Yeah. It was a great era for cinema, where like CGI was just getting to the point where people were confident with it, even though a lot of them probably shouldn't have been, including Matrix 2, which I just watched, and it's pretty embarrassing looking CGI at this point, but Lord of the Rings, and like a lot of movies that did it correctly and, you know, used it responsibly, they did it such a great job with a lot of their visual effects at the time. Is this what we're doing here? We're not taking the elevator, I guess. Oh, am I looking for a particular PO box, or? It's a very conspicuous elevator here. You would think that would be what we're trying to do. Find and retrieve the package. Get to the second floor and find box 731222. When were they telling me that? Well, they're not numbered, so I guess I just have to click every box? There's no way that's the case. There's gotta be like a color on it or something. Oh wait, are these numbered? Yeah. 701, okay. Now we're in business. 721, 7312, it's gotta be here.
Grenade! You've got the package.
Oh,
get it.
Oh, we're in. Are we in toxic gas? That's not good. How do I get more health? Get out of there! Get in the elevator! What are you doing, Niobe? Alright, we probably want to go backwards then? We'll use that health when we need it. Oh wait, our health is going back up. The gas is gone, okay. Or maybe the gas is only in this part of the room? Yeah, look, now our health is going back down. New tip, jumping from behind corners. As you were saying, cool, wonder why they didn't have Trinity as the character. Well, we got to choose from two characters at the beginning, so we don't know who's gonna be in this game. Yeah, we're only like, you know, an hour in. But I'm sure they wanted to, you know, kind of like add, or like put some mystique behind some of their new characters for this second movie. While looking around a corner, press jump. Your character will leap from behind the corner. Press fire to shoot while jumping. Jumping out from behind a corner is a great way to ambush enemies or to move between positions of cover during a battle. Oh, we're coming straight out the front door. Can I just leave? Ah! Oh, jeez. Get behind the cover, and then jump! Cool, that was great. That was really cool. Alright, do it again! Go, go, go! Oh, man. Oh, we got an MP5, okay. Oh, God, this is cool. Okay, hopefully we'll heal here. Oh, jeez. Oh, we have a shotgun. Or a pistol. Oh, baby! Oh, my God. Can I get out through the bathroom again? They got rid of the ladder. Whoa, look at this! Is this what a women's restroom looks like? They have couches? What are we missing out on? Jeez. Can't punch the TV. Alright, let's let the health reload before anything happens here. I love this too, where they're capturing the like frantic running through doors that they always do in the Matrix. That's like a very, well, you can tell where they had like mandates of like, we gotta get this aspect of the Matrix in the game. They're doing a great job so far. The crumbling pillars is a really good touch. Yeah, as they're saying, running between the columns with the marble flying. Exactly, yeah. It feels like they really specifically wanted to get a lot of these pieces of iconography from the Matrix in there.
What the hell happened to you?
Ghost created a distraction for you.
A distraction? Is there a part of the building he didn't set on fire?
That is just what I'm checking out.
The front entrance is a no-go. Have I got an exit?
Hold on, I'm looking at your options. Okay. You're not gonna like it.
Hit me.
Find the manager's office. It's near where you jumped out of the conveyor belt.
On the second floor?
That's the you're not gonna like it part. Just call me when you get there.
Cool. This is technically, like, pretty impressive. Can I jump down, or what am I doing here? Oh, we can just go down here. Sorry. Oh my god. I can't hit them. I can't hit them. Oh, I have three kinds of guns. Oh, wow. Oh, I see what we're doing here. Yeah, cool. Sorry. Ah, damn. Oh, God. Get against the wall. I don't think we can hit that guy. Let's just take a second to heal. Oh, it goes up fast. Sparkle saying the fighting mechanics were surprisingly advanced for the time. Yeah, they look great. The animations are super solid in this game. I'm very impressed. Yeah, I mean, 2003, like, this is a great looking game. The shooting is a little funky, but twin stick shooters weren't exactly, you know, the second analog stick for aim control wasn't really like the gold standard yet. Especially not on the PS2. The PS2 took a really long time to, and obviously the GameCube as well, took a really long time to catch on with like shooters.
Don't move!
Oh my god, I'm stuck, I'm stuck, I'm stuck! Run! We're going shotgun time. Oh wait, we're too far from the shotgun. Got him! Oh my god, this game's really cool. want to check on our save. I wish we could make two slots for the save, but... Yeah, okay, that's in there. Good stuff, ladies and gents. That is going to do it for Enter the Matrix. Starting out here strong. I'll see you guys on the next one. Thank you for joining the show. The channel's called The Voice of Nick. If you want to see more, don't forget to hit the follow button, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.